After everything I've endured and experienced, I cannot believe that I'm about to eat this watermelon. It smells so good. So for 7 days, I'm only going to consume water. No food, no coffee, no juices, no wine, no calories, just water. This should be fun. Lately, I've been feeling a little off balance. My productivity is high, but my enjoyment of what I'm doing is low. I started this year with a set of goals, broken down into four areas: physical health, mental health, creativity, and my spiritual life. My plan was solid, but they were also heavily dependent on my work ethic and my mood. My creativity thrived, but everything else declined. I was feeling sluggish, lethargic, overwhelmed, and just a real lack of mental clarity. I believe this happened for two reasons. The first reason is they were solid goals, but they were set at a time where I had already compromised some of my good habits. Over the holidays, I gave myself a few days to indulge in some treats. And prior to this, three months before this, I had given up sugar completely. And so around the holidays, I allowed myself to have sugar. And we're talking about 2, 3, maybe 4 days of just kind of like allowing myself to indulge in things that taste good, that are not good for you. The second reason is my work was giving me the rewards that I needed, that dopamine I needed, that boost to say that I'm doing well. And so I just put more time into work than anything else and kind of neglected the other areas. There was a lack of mental clarity once again and discipline with my eating, with my taking time out to pray and to meditate and to really feed myself spiritually, as well as working out. This was a huge lesson for me that sometimes you have to be okay with just focusing on one area at a time, and that not all goals must be achieved at the same time. So to continue the story, I got to a point where I realized, actually, I want to do something about this. I want to tilt the scales back the other way. I then decided I want to find a solution. And for me, the chain of unbalance started with my eating habits and, more importantly, my water intake. It literally went from me drinking a gallon of water per day to maybe a glass. So I decided to do a detox, a sort of reset for my body, for my mind, by doing a 7-day water fast. This included me only drinking water, minimal work, minimal activity, minimal brain stimulation, away from social media, just unplugged, just for a moment so I can be still and have a break. The only tech work I did was filming updates for this video. Here's how it went. Day one of my water fast, I've decided to start this with a real positive outlook. Woke up first thing, 1 liter of water. And yeah, I feel really good about it and really looking forward to seeing the results and the difference it will have on my body and my mind and my productivity. This isn't the first fast I've done, but every single fast I've done has its own challenges. Challenge number one for me this morning was the first thing that I do every day is feed my cats. So yeah, having to see their food, not so tempting yet, but I'm sure will get more challenging throughout the week. It's quite disgusting, really. So it's lunchtime. Water on the menu. Not really feeling hungry yet. I guess I would say some of the main challenges have been, other than feeding the cats this morning, making my son lunch, and that was a little bit challenging. And it's just about reminding myself that I can't eat, you know, and sometimes we eat unconsciously. We go to pick out something. I just had to stay very present and just remind myself that I'm in this process and that, you know, it's all about water and detoxing my body and really preparing for what I know is ahead. You know, the two types of hunger, the physical hunger and the mental hunger. There's going to be the habits of, you know, certain times where you're used to eating, just about overcoming those thoughts and being productive. I've probably had about 3 liters of water so far. It's 1 o'clock. So yeah, I'm on a good pace. So it's the end of day one, and I would say that today has been quite smooth, a bit smoother than I expected. But maybe that's a trap. Maybe that's, you know, me coming in with such a positive mindset and coming in with this kind of like, I got this kind of approach. Maybe my mind is tricking me into not feeling hungry. Because I haven't felt hungry today. I think I've drank about just over a gallon of water. And I would say where I did notice a little bit of something was around 5 p.m. I started to prepare dinner for my family. And as I was cooking, I was like, in my mind, I was still making something for me, but at the end of it, there was nothing. And so I had another liter of water. So I think that will be a challenge as the days go on. But I, when I do things like this, I don't try to make the conditions easy for myself. I like to make it uncomfortable. And because that's when I feel as though I'm getting the most out of it. I'm testing my self-control, my willpower. I'm also breaking some of those mental habits of when you smell something you want it, or if you see something you want it. I want to tackle all of the things that have made their way into my life over the last few months, and I welcome this challenge. And I feel that tomorrow is going to be a little bit more difficult. I will update in the morning on how I slept. And yeah, other than feeling not hungry, I've used the bathroom a lot of times today. So yeah, that is a clear sign to me from experience that my body's just not used to having water anymore that quickly. And so yeah, signing out. See you in the morning. Good morning. Day two of my 7-day water fast. Last night was an okay sleep. Other than having to get up to use the bathroom a few times, I think I slept pretty well. I will say though, this morning I was very sluggish. I felt tired. It didn't feel like I had a great sleep. And that's probably because I got up in the night a few times. I don't feel as energetic this morning. It's taken me a while to kind of get my bearings, but I'm going to have 2 liters of water. And potentially switch my strategy of drinking, because yesterday I had 3 liters by lunchtime and then I only had 1 liter for the rest of the day. And so I think I started too heavy and didn't have a good measuring strategy. So today I will try to adjust that. I will think of a plan and update you what I do by lunchtime. So it's lunchtime now, and I realized that I was getting quite bored of the water bottle that I've been drinking out of, and so I decided to kind of give myself a bit of variety to just switch over to my gallon bottle. It's not ideal as it's plastic and I not a fan of drinking out of plastic. But if I give myself variety and switch them, then it will kind of make the water consumption a bit more bearable. I've always wanted a gallon glass bottle, but they're just so heavy. So yeah, what I might do is just pour them into glasses and go from there. But yeah, it's lunchtime, I'm still not hungry. I do feel a slight headache coming on, which I know is normal, and I know will pass, but yeah, so far so good. I feel horrible. I feel hungry, I feel moody, I feel drained. And I think some of this has to do with the fact that I went for a walk today. So today was the first day where I actually was doing something that required a lot of energy. So yeah, I officially feel hungry. The last 6-7 hours slowly crept up on me. So now it's getting real. But we keep going. I will check in the morning and see how my sleep was. I'm gonna have to have an early night tonight because I don't want to be awake through this. So good night. So it's day 3 of my water fast, and I just want to start off by saying that I didn't record this morning. And the reason for that was I had a horrible night's sleep and just had to keep getting up and going to the bathroom, and I was just hungry and it felt like I had a storm in my stomach. I thought it would start to feel better, but it just got worse and worse throughout the night, and all I could do was think of food. I almost considered giving up. I thought, okay, maybe I've got what I need out of this, and you know, 2 days is still an accomplishment. But then I fell asleep and woke up this morning, and then I was still hungry. I just had to keep going and just really remind myself that no, this is a journey, and it's gonna have ups and downs, and it's important for me to persist and commit to the journey. And so just kept drinking water. So just telling myself, water's gonna fill me up, water's gonna fill me up. The hunger pains were so intense that I knew that I wouldn't make it through the day unless I did something to distract myself. And so I decided to do some reading and do some writing in my lunch break to really just try and put my mind somewhere else. And as I was writing, you know, contributing towards my new book, I also started to write down some of my thoughts and feelings, just trying to take it out of my body and put it onto paper, just to give me some form of clarity. And it really helped. I need to occupy my mind in a productive way while I'm cleansing, while I'm detoxing. And so yeah, my mood has been better today based on those small changes that I made. And I think that is me crossing a milestone. And yeah, hopefully signs of better days to come. I still had a headache. It was very bad last night and for the beginning of this morning, but as the day's gone on, it's feeling a lot better, so I'm happy about that. One thing that I notice is that my tongue's gone white. I've read about this. It's happened to me before when I've done fasts. So also another sign that my body is actually doing something, and I feel good about that when I can see signs. So yes, another day, another gallon of water. Good night, I'll check in with you tomorrow. So it's day 4 of my 7-day water fast, and I have to say, after what was a very, very huge struggle yesterday, I had a fantastic night's sleep. I woke up feeling energized and just really alive. One of the main driving forces behind this has been mindset. And it's so important that when you're doing a task like this, you have the right mindset. And it just helped this morning when I woke up, I went into my office and my daughter had left me a lovely, encouraging, motivational speech in the form of Scrabble pieces. And just those little bits of nudges can do so much for you when you're on a journey like this that's so challenging. I feel really, really alert. My skin feels really cool, almost like I can feel the water on the surface of my skin. And it just feels like everything is in slow motion, but I'm at super speed. And I like that feeling because it feels like my productivity levels will be enhanced. And so, I'm going to drink 2 liters of this water and get on with my day. So it's lunchtime now, and I must say, it's like I said earlier on this morning, it's been really, really energetic. I feel more awake, more alert, and I find I'm getting thirsty. Even though I'm drinking loads of water, I'm getting thirsty, and that is a sign of my body just wants water because that's all it knows right now. And so I'm going to take this time to do something productive during my lunch hour, my son's asleep, and perhaps do some writing, some reading, and just see what genius I can muster up today. So I will see you this evening. So that's another day done. I was able to do some good writing today. Overall, I would say this has been the best day, other than day one where I was a bit arrogant and was like, this is easy, who needs food kind of thing. But today, it's felt good. I think just removing the hunger pains does a lot for me, and just not being so drained and lethargic gives me the space to really think and see things clearly. And that does a lot for me in terms of how I live and my the system that I put in place for how my day runs. And so overall, I feel like I have definitely crossed the line, and now I'm stepping into that limitless mode where I can create incredible things. So end of day 4, nothing but good things to report. Stay tuned, see you tomorrow. So it's day 5 of my 7-day water fast. I had a good sleep last night, but I woke at 4 a.m. and then my brain was just on overdrive, and so I couldn't really get back into a deep one. I started my day by sharing the love a bit, considering I've been taking in so much water. It was time for me to water my plants. There's something about plants that make me feel calm and also just a bit more at peace. And I think it's their patience during the different seasons and how they communicate their needs so delicately. It kind of reminded me of my 5 years plant-based video when I said we give our plants water and not cola for a reason. Doing this fast has definitely shown me how nature is filled with so much energy, and that water really is the key. But I would say that I'm feeling pretty good today, energetic, I would say it's not as energetic as I was maybe yesterday and I think the day before, but that's probably because I woke so early. I think my body's really starting to function at its optimal level. I will say though that I've noticed that when I get up too quickly, I do feel a bit dizzy, a bit lightheaded, but I know that's normal. And so what I've been doing is monitoring my heart, and everything's great. In fact, the numbers show that they're quite similar to when I'm at peak performance and training and stuff. So considering I'm doing nothing but just drinking water, it's quite impressive to see. It also was quite interesting, I don't know if I can zoom in here, but it was interesting to see as I zoomed into my skin, I could see this kind of like PVA glue type flakiness kind of thing with my skin. I'll definitely shoot another scene so you can get a better look at that if you're interested in the flaky face. But that's a good sign also, and I'm okay with shedding away anything that I don't need. And so it's really interesting to see the things that my body wants to do but cannot usually do, because it's using so much energy to break down foods that probably my body was never really intended to be trying to digest. So today I drank a gallon and a half of water, and yeah, pretty easy. And yeah, just, I feel quite refreshed today. So that's my wrap up for today. See you guys tomorrow. Alexa, play my backing music.
Okay.
Day 6 of my water fast, and today has been very reflective. With this kind of mental clarity, I can do one of two things. I can be productive and start creating, which I'm not allowed to do, or I can really use the time to think about my relationship with food, technology, my physical health, and whatever other adjustments that I can make to contribute towards my well-being. I started writing up a refeeding plan, something that can ease me back into normality without giving my body too much shock. Along with this, I started working on a workout plan, something for my physical health and just getting back active again. I didn't want to go too deep into it, as I didn't want to skip steps, as today is day 6, and I didn't want to look too far ahead in the future, as I'm trying to remain present. I don't want anything in my life to feel like a chore or a burden, and so I'm trying to keep all of my future adjustments to my routine as minimal as possible. Today I drank 2 gallons of water. Today was a record, and I felt pretty good about that, as there's been a steady progression and increase of my water intake throughout the week. But also the day just seems to drag, and with me not having much to do, drinking water seems to just fill that time perfectly. But I'll also say my reflective task today definitely did help to pass by some time, and it wasn't fully crossing over into the creative spectrum, so I still stayed on track according to my rules. It's my final day tomorrow. I'm looking forward to it, but for now I need to go and get some rest. Alexa, turn off the lights.
Okay.
So today is day 7 of my 7-day water fast. After everything I've endured and experienced, I cannot believe that I'm about to eat this watermelon. It smells so good. But before I do, I wanted to share some of the lessons and challenges that I've learned along my journey. I'll start first with the challenges. Not being able to eat while still preparing food for my family and having to feed the cat every morning, that was a challenge. I can confirm that I was never tempted to eat the cat food, but it was more seeing them desire something and then have that desire, that craving quenched and satisfied. I know what that feels like, but I couldn't partake in it. But one thing I did learn from it is that it gave me a deepened level of discipline. And I said on one of the earlier days that I try to make it as challenging as possible, because I want to overcome any types of limitations or weaknesses within my own mind. And that, having to prepare the food each day, definitely accomplished that for me. The challenge showed me that I have a deep level of discipline, and that my motivation was strong enough to see it through. And everything comes back to motivation. Why are you doing this, and how much does it mean to you? The second challenge for me was being still. Once I got over that original hurdle of just low energy and hunger, I got this boost of energy that I wanted to do something with, but I couldn't create, I couldn't be productive. And that was quite a challenge for me, because to do so would have been against my rules. That wasn't easy, but it was very necessary, as it reminded me that it's okay to just be and not always have to do. Some of the things that I learned along this journey are how connected the mind and the body really are. I've heard a lot about it, but going through it with my own personal experience this week, I've seen that they work in harmony. Physical hunger is real, but once you get past that, you have to deal with the mind games. Looking for any excuse to cut it short, dizziness, headaches, tiredness, hunger, even filming this, I had to overcome the temptation to quit on several occasions. In doing this, I feel like I unlocked another level of mental strength and resilience, and then my body responded. I also learned that by its very nature, the body heals itself. The problem comes when we fill it with so many bad foods that it uses too much energy trying to break down stuff that it doesn't have the space and capacity to do what it wants to do. By giving my body a break from food, it was able to shed skin, regulate my heart, use fat for energy, reset my gut, give me mental clarity, and the type of feeling of accomplishment that I would get from usually fulfilling my goals, the same one that I was striving to do at the beginning of the year, but without having to do much of anything at all. I also learned that it's important for us not to compare our journeys to other people's. All of our bodies are different. We all respond to things differently and come in at different levels of experience. I had watched a lot of videos before I started this, and most people spoke of day one and two being miserable, and then it getting better for day three and so on. But for me, I found day one and two quite easy, apart from the evening of day two, and day three was horrible. Day four and five is when I activated my superpowers. It's important to note that I've done fast before, and so I already came in with a reference point of what my body can handle. But even in doing this, I realized that with age, things change, and so I responded differently this time compared to prior times. While this has been a great experience, it's important to also note that this is supposed to be a detox, a reset. It's not a sustainable way of life or living. And the body needs nutrients. And the question is, which types of food do we use to fuel our body to get those nutrients? That's where the problems come into play. But with that being said, after 12 and a half gallons of water, my skin feels amazing. My joints don't feel achy. I have a cool charge all over me, and I feel more awake and refreshed. I came for mental clarity, didn't weigh myself before nor after, nor take photos to compare two physical versions of myself, as it's not about that for me. But I can say that I feel mentally lighter, and that it's a great base for what I'm about to create next. Anyway, after 168 hours of no food, I'm about to eat this watermelon now. If you've managed to watch this to the end, thank you so much. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you've liked what you've seen, feel free to subscribe. And until next time, stay blessed, and I wish you better days. It's incredible. But I can say that I feel mentally lighter, and but I can't, my mouth is watering, I can smell it.
It's 12 o'clock, Dad, you've officially done it.